All right. I don't have any injuries for you right now, so I'll have to get them to you tomorrow. But my hat goes off to the Ravens and the city here of Baltimore. You've got a great football team. We appreciate your hospitality. It's a great environment to play in. And then how about the Chiefs? You know, I mean, what a great deal that was. I thought our guys played hard, aggressive football. It always starts with the offensive defensive line. They came out, you know, with a purpose here and played their hearts out. Pat Mahomes did a great job again, as he normally does, but starting the game off with 11 completions, straight completions, that's something special. And then to manage the game, things that get kind of thrown by the side is him taking a sack there at the end. So as opposed to trying to fit the ball in, he took the sack, kept the clock running, good things happened there at that particular time. So, and then our defense was outstanding. We were able to get a lead, and we were able to maintain that lead and did it with great personality there. So as they've done throughout the season. But my hat goes out to Spags, to Nags, and to Tobe for the jobs that they've done as coordinators, putting things together, and most of all keeping the hope up, right, when things weren't maybe going as well. MVS is a picture of that. So people coming down on him everywhere. He keeps it right there and does a great job with it. I mean, I thought he was just phenomenal. That kid, he's taking a beating here, and he was able to just hang in there and battle. So, anyways, time's yours.
Andy, that pass to MVS at the end, was that difficult to call?
Yeah, it was. No, it wasn't hard to call. I mean, just a couple words. It was zero blitz. We knew it was going to be zero blitz, and or at least had a good idea. I mean, you never really know, but we thought we knew. So, and it was, and it got MVS, you know, in a great position right there. I'm losing my voice here. Got him in a great position to make the play.
Travis was unlike we've seen him in quite some time during the week. I mean, he was talking about how this game meant more to him than any other game. And certainly before the game and after the game, he looked like he was pumped up. What's going on with him?
Travis is always fired up. You know, he's always fired up. But with the playoffs, he's even more so. And so I never worry about him being ready to go. He's always right there and just brings that emotion to the guys, that just secure feeling that we're going to go get this thing no matter what. And don't think of anything. Don't think of anything opposite that. We're going to get it. So I appreciate his attitude always. And he's just added a little bit to it. And I think that week off helped him. So just for him to be able to get a little bit of rest and get in there and go.
Andy, this team has been doubted at certain times throughout the season. Just what stands out about the adversity of this group to punch another ticket to the Super Bowl?
Yeah, I mean, easily you could fold. I told you that after our game, our last game against Buffalo, the thing that stood out to me most was just the positive attitude on the sideline. Through the highs and the lows of positive attitude, that kind of tells you the season, gives you the whole story there. The guys never doubted. They just, you know, they put themselves in a position where you had a chance, and they you know, they took care of that. And a great attitude on this team.
Just related to that, Andy, I mean, when you tell people the story of how you got here, is that what it is? And this is a little different chapter this season than it's been.
Yeah, listen, I think so. One thing, Vahe, it's tough to back-to-back-to-back seasons. That's a tough thing. You played a lot of football games, and you've got to work through that. You know, you got to work through that mentally. That's not an easy thing. And so I'm so happy for the guys and how they handled that, you know, and When it came time to put the hammer down, they put the hammer down, which was important. And the best part is we're not done. You know, we've got another game, and you love these seasons to carry on as long as they can possibly carry on, and we're there. And that's and now we got to get right back at it and start grinding for whoever wins this game here.
You were talking about this a little bit before. Is there a cumulative mental wear and tear? It's not just one season. Isn't it a big cumulative, all these years put together? What does that say about your team getting here with that?
Yeah, so what you get when I say that, what you get is everybody's best shot. So every week you're going to get the best shot. And so you get, there are no games off for any of that stuff. There's not any in the NFL anyways, but there are no games off. There's no light opponent. You've got to bring it every week. And so, again, to be in this position, that tells you a little bit of something about the mental makeup of this football team.
All right, we got to go really fast here. Go ahead, Mark.
When you talked earlier, Andy, about sort of keeping hope up throughout all this season, did you have your hope built up whatever any moments that you sort of doubted your ability to be back in this spot?
I've never doubted, no. That's not how we roll, so never doubt.
Go ahead.
Andy, your defensive game plan, how difficult was that to come up with, and how do you feel like you guys executed?
I thought we did a great job. That's an explosive offense. Start looking at categories of efficiency, and they're number one in a few spots there. So you've got to make sure when you come in with that you keep that quarterback somewhat in the pocket the best you can, and he's an unbelievable competitor. So I thought our guys were able to do that up front. I thought our linebackers did a good job. We asked them to not only cover tight ends, a great tight end, but also these receivers at times. So we could, Spags had a variety of things he was throwing at him at the offense, and I thought our guys did a nice job with all that.
Last one.
And Coach, speaking of defense, the defensive guys had shirts that said, "In Spags we trust." Just want to get your thoughts on that.
Yeah, no. I heard it was because his wife moved in, to back here, to Kansas City, which is a great thing. She's also a phenomenal cook. We appreciate her desserts. She makes great banana cream pudding, which she's done every week this season. So, Spags, I've known him a long time, since the old college days. So I just appreciated his effort and putting all these game plans together. He's not, he and I are about almost the same age. So we've seen a couple games.
All right. Thank you.
All right, good.